class. So in this video, we're going to talk about the White-Vincent method and how you use that to adjust tonicity of various solutions. Typically for ophthalmic and sometimes nasal preparations, what normally happens is you would have your active ingredient, and to that you add some specified volume of purified water to form an isotonic solution. After that, you subsequently add sufficient volume of an isotonic buffered solution to have your total preparation, or the volume of your total preparation. The question often is, how do you know how much volume of purified water to add to your drug to have the isotonic solution? That's where we use the White-Vincent equation. And the White-Vincent equation is equal to the way the omega times E times 111.1. Now, the omega refers to the weight of drug in grams. It's the weight of drug in grams. And E is the sodium chloride equivalent. So normally what happens is you want to know, how do you get units of volume from this equation? How is it possible that this equation gives you volume? Now, as it turns out, your weight is in grams as shown. Your E is equivalent, sodium chloride equivalent, which is dimensionless, it has no units. And then your factor, the 111.1, is actually the inverse of 0.9% sodium chloride solution, which is isotonic by nature. So what that means is you have 100 milliliters divided by 0.9 grams. The grams cancel out and you are left with units of milliliters, because the grams cancel out and your E is dimensionless. So your volume has units of milliliters, always. Now let's look at some strategic examples to make this concept really clear. Know how you go about solving your questions or dealing with real life situations, and how this approach can be utilized for different formulations and different scenarios. The first example requires you to calculate the volume of purified water to make this preparation isotonic. And as it turns out, your drug is epinephrine hydrochloride with an E value of 0.29. Now, in this particular formulation, it is 0.5% weight by volume. And then your total volume here is 15 milliliters. Now, how do you go about calculating the volume? Let's take a look at that. Like I talked about in class, it's really good to have some kind of steps in your mind as to how you go about solving these kind of situations or problems. And so for step one, you first determine the amount of epinephrine hydrochloride required for the formulation. Now, this is important because your equation, which is your White-Vincent equation, requires you to have the weight in grams. So we can't just substitute 0.5% in that equation. We need to know the actual weight in grams. So that's what you do in this first step. Now, since epinephrine hydrochloride is 0.5%, what we're going to end up having is 0.5 grams in 100 milliliters. But we need to adjust this to the total volume of our formulation. So that becomes 0.5 grams in divided by 100 milliliters times 15 milliliters. Now, when we do the math, you end up having 0.075 grams. Now, what do you do next? You now have your weight in grams, you know your E value from the question, so you don't really need to go look in tables and charts. Now, let me remind you that if you don't have the E value given to you, you need to always go to these tables and charts, which you can find in resources like Remittance. So to calculate the volume of purified water that we need to make the solution isotonic, we're going to substitute the weight that we just calculated in step one. We're going to substitute the E value given in the question into the White-Vincent equation. So how that works then is now your volume, which is V, is going to be equal to 0.075 times the E value, which is 0.29 times 111.1. When you multiply all these numbers, you're going to end up with V equals 2.42 milliliters. So what this then means is you're going to dissolve 0.075 grams of epinephrine hydrochloride in 2.42 milliliters of purified water. And this is going to give you an isotonic solution. You're then going to add sufficient quantities of your isotonic buffered solution. And actually, for this example, that would be a volume of 12.58 milliliters. Now, because both your initial solution with epinephrine hydrochloride dissolved in 2.42 milliliters of purified water is isotonic, and your buffer is also isotonic, the combination will be isotonic. Let's look at another example. And this basically is just going to reinforce the concepts in the first example. And then in the example following this particular one, we look at situations where you have multiple components. Okay. So here again, you are required to calculate the total volume of purified water required to make the solution isotonic. Your drug is ingredient Z, E value 0.18. Now that is 2% weight by volume in your formulation. Your total volume is 30 milliliters. So step one, we're going to calculate the amount in grams, of ingredient Z required for this formulation. Now, since ingredient Z is 2%, we're going to end up having 2 grams in 100 milliliters. And now you are going to multiply that ratio by 30 milliliters, which is the total volume. And that gives us 0.6 grams. In step two, we're going to substitute these values into the White-Vincent equation. And in doing so, we end up having V equals 0.6 times 0.18 times 111.1. This gives a value of V equals 12 milliliters. So what this means is you dissolve 0.6 grams of ingredient Z in 12 milliliters of purified water. That gives an isotonic solution. And to that, we're going to add sufficient quantities of isotonic buffered solution. And naturally, if you end up adding 18 milliliters of your buffered solution, you have a total volume of 30 ml, which is isotonic. Now, sometimes you have multiple components in your preparation. So basically more than one ingredient. And this example illustrates how you handle that. Basically, you're going to resort to the generalized form of the White-Vincent equation, which is given you. So you have a lot more terms in there. And the key thing is to know that it is the sum of the products of the weight in grams and the E values of your various drugs. That's what it is. Your volume is going to be given you by the sum of the products of your weight and your E values, all multiplied by the 111.1 factor. So let's look at an example. In this example, you are required to calculate, first of all, the volume in milliliters of purified water and also the volume in milliliters of the buffer that you need for this prescription. Your total volume is 50 milliliters and you have homotropin hydrobromide with this E value 0.17 and its weight concentration of 1%. You have chlorobutanol E value 0.24, weight concentration 0.2%. So here again, your first step is always to determine the amount of these drugs in grams that are present in your formulation. Step one says you first determine what these are going to be or what the weight in grams is going to be for homotropin hydrobromide and chlorobutanol. So let's start with homotropin hydrobromide. Now, since this is 1%, what this means is we have 1 gram in 100 milliliters, and then we multiply this by the total volume of the preparation, 50 milliliters, and that gives us 0.5 grams. We can now also determine the amount in grams of chlorobutanol, just like we did for homotropin hydrobromide in the previous slide. And this should be 0.2 grams divided by 100 milliliters. We multiply that ratio by 50 milliliters, and that gives us 0.1 grams. So at this stage, we have all the information that we need to substitute into the White-Vincent equation, the generalized form that we just talked about. So let's do that then. We're going to have V equals 0.5 times 0.17, which represents weight of drug and E value for homotropin hydrobromide. And we're going to add that to the product of 0.1 and 0.24, which represents the weight and the E value of chlorobutanol. We then multiply this sum by 111.1, that gives us a volume of 12.11 milliliters. So this is the volume of purified water that we need to make this solution isotonic. So what typically is going to happen is we're going to dissolve in real life 0.5 grams of homotropin hydrobromide and 0.1 grams of chlorobutanol in 12.11 milliliters of purified water. Now to this, we're going to add 37.89 milliliters, which represents the volume of isotonic buffer that is needed to make a total volume of 50 milliliters. So in this video, we looked at how you can use the White-Vincent method to adjust tonicity. We talked about how it is that you need to use a very good stepwise approach to get your solution or your answers all the time. The key thing to remember is you always need to have your weight of ingredients in grams. And then you substitute that together with your E value into the White-Vincent equation. You have different situations that can happen. You can do this for a single ingredient or multiple ingredients. Now, I'm sure you are confident and competent to do all kinds of different situations, different examples. Wasn't that fun? See you sometime later. And if you have any questions, Be sure to send me an email. It's mdanquah@csu.edu. mdanquah@csu.edu.